Match geometry effect in SwiftUI is a stunning tool that allows for seamless, eye-catching transitions between views, creating a polished and professional feel in your app. Despite its visual appeal, many developers shy away from using it because it can be tricky to implement correctly, especially when handling complex layouts or animations. In this video, I'll walk you through a step-by-step guide on how to master matched geometry effect, demystifying its complexity and empowering you to use it effectively in your projects. Do you want me to be your mentor? Go ahead and check out the link in the description. More on this later in the video. So today we are going to talk about matched geometry effect and how to use it properly in SwiftUI. So what I have done is just created this simple SwiftUI view. It has two circles, one red, the other one green in a horizontal stack. And the red is 200 by 200, the green is 100 by 100. And then we have this button, tap me. We're just going to do with this with animation because it's, match geometry effect works actually better and it should be done with animation. Okay, so this is our setup. What do we need to understand? Well, match geometry effect is basically taking one view and then animating it to the other view. And we are going to do that with these two circles. We are going to animate the red circle into the green circle and back from the green to the red. So for that, we actually need a Boolean value. Is it active? So should it animate from here to there or the other way around? So let's add that state variable at state private var is active of type Boolean and it's set to false. By the way, this is just a simple example so you understand how match geometry effect actually works. Okay, so is active, I'm just going to toggle it. Is active dot toggle. Okay, that's fine. We have the trigger. Now, how do we actually implement the match geometry effect? Having a SwiftUI mentor can fast track your progress by providing clear, actionable guidance tailored to your goals. With my mentoring sessions, you'll avoid common pitfalls, learn best practices, and gain a deeper understanding of SwiftUI concepts that directly impact your app development skills. Whether it's optimizing your code, solving complex challenges, or staying ahead with the latest features, mentorships ensure you're learning effectively and efficiently. Join my sessions to accelerate your growth, build confidence, and achieve your goals faster than going it alone. The link is down in the description. When you type out match geometry effect, and let's just do that. And by the way, you have to do that before the frame because we are going to have the property of frame in just a second on that later. So matched geometry effect. As you can see, it has an ID and then an in and then properties, anchor and is source. We are going to talk about all of these in just a second. But let's take a look first at the namespace. It's at namespace.id. It's basically tying the two views together. So let's just comment this one out and let's create a namespace. So at namespace private var namespace. Namespace. There we go. And if you have multiple of these match geometry effects, then you need to set up different namespaces because now we are just going to tie two of these together. So let's do that. Matched geometry effect. Let's just use the one with just a simple one. ID. Well, that is the ID of those two. And you will see in just a second how we are going to switch that. Let's just call this circle. It has to be hashable. Okay. A string will do. And then let's add the namespace. Namespace. Again, this is how we are tying the two together. So what we are going to do is just copy this out and paste it in there. And actually, we didn't do anything because now it will say, okay, now the green should be the same position because the frame is the default value as our green one, the red one. Of course, we don't want to do that. So we are going to toggle the circle, the ID of our green view. So it will be circle when this is active, and it will be an empty string when it's not active. So let's just add this one is active, question mark, then it's just going to be circle. It's just going to be an empty string. So now you can see that it actually, it just jumped back in to its proper place where, you know, it's started off. And then let's just tap over here. And now you see that the circle red is just going to go all the way down. And if we add, let's just have an opacity over here. Oh, sorry. An opacity of 0.2. You see that? See, that's an opacity. And if I tap over here, it's just hiding beneath it, because that's what we actually wanted it to do. But now what I want to do is just set also the source and the anchor and some other properties. Okay, so this is fine for now as a default value, but I'm going to set the source. Let's just say comma is source to be true, and then let's set is source to be false right over here. So is source false. Okay, now let's see what's going on. Really interesting. So you see now the circle of red is the source, and the green is actually popping up to the size, to the frame actually, of our red one. Interesting, right? So what we can also add is an anchor. So let's add an anchor of, let's just have center. That's the default one right over here. But we can also set the anchor before the is source. Anchor, there we go. Come on, anchor. Of dot, let's just have this as bottom. Why not? And now let's see what's going to happen. You see, the source is center for our red one, but it's bottom for the green one. And of course, you can play around with it. You can see it's just jumping to there. I'm just going to put it back to center so you can see it. That is just going to go all the way up. By the way, center is the default. Okay, and finally, let's talk about the properties. So what properties should the match geometry effect affect? Okay, so that's before the anchor. So properties. There we go, properties. And you can add a dot and you will see frame, position, or size. Frame is by default. Let's just go for size. And let's see that. You see, it's the same thing because we are setting up in the source. Is source is true. Now let's do this one on the other one, the green one, which is not the source. And that has to be added after the namespace right over here. Now it will be really interesting. So, oh, really nice. Because now we have the property of size. So it's not just going to go to the red circle. It's just going to change its size, which is really, really nice. Of course, there is frame, position, and size. On a position, you can just change, let's just see what the position does, and just going to go back to frame right over here, the default one, frame, and then let's just see position. Okay, there we go. Now you see the frame is not changing, therefore the green one, the green circle is not blowing up, is just going for the position. And of course, you may have an array, so position 2 and then frame, but basically the frame is the same. You know, you can have a frame. There we go. Now it's just going to scale up, and also its position, but the frame also has its position. So yeah, whatever. So let's move this back to frame, and usually, like 90% of the time, you are going to go with these default ones, like the properties is frame and the anchor is center. And you might want to tweak the is source, because otherwise it's just going to be the default one, you know, and maybe you don't want to use that one. So that's how easy to use match geometry effect. If you like these types of tutorials, I highly recommend my mentoring sessions, 1-hour Zoom meeting with me. The link is down in the description.